The Korean Navy is showing off its state-of-the-art rescuer, Tongyang, but the ship has been rocked by controversy over its sonar. Fishermen in the Yellow Sea staged a protest in their boats to urge the government to address illegal Chinese fishing there. And Korean bus companies have been collecting profits driving from Seoul government subsidies, raising serious questions.
Hello and welcome to News Today on KBS World. It's Thursday, November 27th. I'm Luke Clary. The Korean Navy is showing off its state-of-the-art rescuer, Tongyang, demonstrating the ship's performance and structure, as well as its deployment readiness. But the vessel was operated without its key asset, the sonar, which has been at the heart of significant controversy.
The controversial rescuer, Tongyang, showed up in waters off Busan to carry out a mock rescue mission. The minesweeper Ong Jin was also deployed to exchange communications with the Tongyang.
여기는 춘천산 수신 완료 끝 270도 5m 기동 시작.
Allegations of corruption in the defense industry had erupted around the Tongyang when a flawed sonar was found installed on the ship. So the probe information from a minesweeper is essential to the rescuer's attempt in locating targets. Given the controversy, the Tongyang had turned off its faulty sonar buoy during the demonstration. Other than underwater exploration, the salvage and rescue vessel performed towing, salvaging, firefighting, and other functions normally.
미충족 장비 이종을 제외한 전 장비가 정상 작동되고 구조 임무 수행이 가능함을 확인하였습니다.
The Korean Navy plans to take the Tongyang first and then replace the problematic sonar with a new one. It takes 2 years to fix the sonar problem, but the Navy claims that the early deployment of the Tongyang is inevitable because the Gwangyang, the 47-year-old rescuer, is too outdated to be kept in service. Military authorities will meet this Friday to discuss the deployment of the $144 million rescue ship with defective parts. However, no military official has stepped up to take responsibility for the corruption allegations surrounding the Tongyang.
Fishermen in the Yellow Sea staged a protest in their fishing boats, urging the government to devise measures that would prevent illegal fishing by Chinese fishermen.
Hundreds of Chinese fishing boats with their lights on are lined up against the horizon. A crackdown by authorities does nothing to scare them. When the winds are strong, Chinese boats marked with the Chinese national flag evacuate en masse to the sea off Pengyang Island. Korean fishermen staged a protest in their fishing boats in the Yellow Sea near the military demarcation line. Instead of nets, they put up banners urging the government to take measures to stop illegal fishing. In addition to illegal fishing, Chinese fishermen also steal or damage fishing equipment installed by Koreans. As a result, Korean fishermen continue to sustain losses in addition to the numerous difficulties they face in making a living.
여기는 5만 원 사와도 못 보여서 사와야 돼. 사비만 해도 60만 원에서 100만 원이야. 그러니까 5구가 없으면 이게 고기를 못 잡을 거 아니야.
After the protest, the fishermen poured out their complaints.
고기 잡을 자리도 없고, 5구도 없고, 이거 뭐 허정세월 보내다 뭐 나는 춘수세 겨울은 되고, 먹을 게 있어야지, 잡을 게 있어야지. 우리는 그냥 배 다 인수시키고 정부에서 다 맡아요.
The Yellow Sea are urging the government to devise measures by early next month.
In Korea, local governments make up bus company shortfalls in order to boost the public good of mass transportation means. But it turns out that the bus companies have been collecting profits driving from Seoul metropolitan government subsidies.
It costs more than $90,000 to purchase a typical city bus. A bus company pays for the vehicles first, and then the Seoul Metropolitan Government subsidizes the entire cost of the purchase over 9 years while the buses are in use. This is, in essence, the city of Seoul buying the buses for the bus operators. But the profits from scrapping the buses are being taken by the bus companies.
차량에서 소유권이 아주 대표적인 일을 제가 하는데 회사 가게까지 전체 감당하는 것은 멀리 되게 만듭니다.
Since 2009, 66 bus operators have gained almost $9.2 million in profit from junking the buses. The Board of Audit and Inspection of Korea noted that although the Seoul City government has been making up for the bus company's shortfall of over $181 million every year, it has failed to collect profit from the bus scrapping business. The city also did not properly collect the profits generated by the advertisements placed inside the buses. Advertisement income is included in the transportation revenue category jointly managed by the city government and the bus companies. But the regulation was revised this year so that the income would be directed only to the bus companies. As a result, the bus operators were able to keep all of the nearly $907,000 in advertisement deals from 2013 alone.
버스 매각 대금과 광고 수입 등을 수입으로 계산해야지만 시민의 혈세를 줄일 수 있는 것 아니겠습니까? 그 관리 감독해야 될 서울시 제대로 관리해서.
The Seoul Metropolitan Council plans to request that the bus operators return the money from selling the buses in order to silence the allegations of wasting the city budget on the bus subsidy program.
The last Wednesday of every month in Korea is Culture Day. President Park Geun-hye yesterday attended a sports event where she stressed the importance of promoting exercise in the era of longer life expectancy.
This exercise was developed this year to promote public health. It's a fast-paced exercise featuring elements of aerobics. President Park Geun-hye and rhythmic gymnast Son Yeon-jae also donned training suits to take part in the exercise. The president also visited the practice facilities of a table tennis club.
대통령께서 탁구를 즐겨 치신다는 말씀을 드렸습니다.
네, 그래요?
김혜수는 못해가지고 감각이 떨어졌어요.
박 played a game of table tennis with national team coach Yoo Nam-kyu. The presidential office explained that Park enjoyed playing table tennis when she was younger. Attending an event marking Culture Day, the president told of how she used to exercise 2 hours a day and urged the public to exercise more to prepare for a longer life.
그 덕분인지 지금도 그 여러 가지 그 업무가 그 고된 일들이 많아도 그런 대로 잘 견디는 것 같아요.
Park added that by keeping fit, the public can help minimize healthcare costs.
December 1st is World AIDS Day. Countries around the world will hold events to highlight the fight against AIDS and attack prejudices surrounding the disease. But Korean AIDS patients are still suffering because there are still very few hospitals willing to accept them.
Roughly 1,000 people were newly infected with HIV in Korea last year. But prejudice against those with HIV or AIDS is still prevalent, and some hospitals even refuse to perform surgery on these patients. It is estimated that hundreds of seriously ill AIDS patients require hospitalization or nursing assistance in Korea, but there is almost no hospital they can go to.
우리 관련인들은 아파도 아프다고 이야기하지 못합니다. 아파도 들어갈 요양병원이 마련되어 있지 않기 때문입니다. 중증 AIDS 환자들은 안정된 장소가 아니라 종합병원에 전전하거나.
There was a convalescent hospital for AIDS patients designated by the Ministry of Health and Welfare, but the hospital was released from the contract over a patient mismanagement problem. Now AIDS patients have nowhere to turn to. The absence of hospitals forces them to stay at home, causing great hardships for their families who look after them. In marking World AIDS Day on December 1st, HIV carriers and human rights activists have called for the establishment of a national convalescent home for AIDS patients.
An ancient vessel that was used to transport grain in the Goryeo era and sank on its way from South Jeolla province to the capital city of Gaegyeong was discovered in 2010. The ship has been restored and now provides insight into the shipbuilding technologies of the Goryeo period.
A wooden ship that was used to transport grain in the Yellow Sea 8 centuries ago navigates the waters once again. The original ship was discovered in 2010 in the waters off Mado Island in Taean, South Chungcheong Province. The ship has been restored to its original state by weaving bamboo to make the sails and hammering in wooden nails. Measuring 15 meters long and 3.2 meters tall, the ship transported up to 1,030 kilogram rice sacks at a time. At the time of its discovery, the ship also contained a wooden tag, which played the same role as modern-day shipping invoices. The tag was marked with the year 1208, which serves as further proof that the ship was built during the Goryeo period. Named after the area of its discovery, Mado 1, the ship is expected to provide valuable clues to help understand the shipbuilding technologies and daily lives of people in the Goryeo era.
과거에 우리의 그 배들이 어떻게 운행을 하고 어떻게 만들어졌으며 어떠한 경로를 가지고 이 역사에 등장을 했는지 이 실체를 밝혀보는 좋은 기회가 됐습니다.
The Cultural Heritage Administration plans to relocate the ship to a conservation hall of underwater cultural heritage that is soon to be built in Taean, South Chungcheong Province, where it will be put on display for educational purposes.
Some 6 million people visit the Hanok village in Jeonju, Jeolla Province every year. They can treat themselves there to a variety of local delicacies. However, visitors are sometimes disappointed by the selfish business practices of some of Jeonju's restaurants.
The Hanok village in Jeonju, North Jeolla Province is packed with tourists. Long lines form in front of famous restaurants. Tasting local delicacies is one of the primary pleasures of traveling.
전주로 이렇게 한옥 마을 와 보니까 색다르고 또 먹을 것도 많고 그래서 문어꼬치도 맛있고.
How hygienic are the restaurants? An inspection team checked the facilities to find out. One restaurant is filled with dust and frozen ingredients are placed haphazardly on the floor.
내놓은 것이 여기서 내놓은 것이 아니에요.
In another store, inspectors are drawn into a dispute with the owner over a cooking table and a showcase encroaching onto the sidewalk.
여기.
Illegally expanded stores pose inconveniences to pedestrians who are forced to take a detour, but the owners don't seem to care. Roughly 50 stores, 20% of the restaurants in the Hanok village, cook and sell food without so much as registering with authorities.
그 식품 위생법에 위반을 해서 영업을 하는 행위에 대해서는 저희들이 수시로 지속적으로 근절이 될 수 있도록 저희들이 단속을.
Some 6 million people visit the Jeonju Hanok village each year. The brazen practices of some selfish shop owners are hurting the reputation of the popular tourist destination.
What are the big differences between Korean and Western paintings? The boundaries between the two artistic genres have collapsed as artists adopt and embrace the merits of both. Let's take a look at the new artistic trends.
The studio of famous Joseon Dynasty artist Kim Hong-do was recreated in vivid colors. His representative work on groups of Taoist immortals were redrawn in bright colors, as if it had been a colored painting in the first place. Interesting and suggestive symbols are hidden here and there in the painting, like Kim's image in the mirror and a wing signifying his artistic spirit.
동양화를 보는 것 같은 느낌도 들면서 서양화적인 요소들도 많고 그래서 굉장히 이렇게 호기심을 자극하는 그림.
A Western-style artist created unique artworks by adopting Korean artistic touches.
동양적인 거에 가까이 올 수도 있으면서 서양적인 것도 어느 정도 섞여서 이게 조화로운 저 나름대로 그런 어떤 화면이 구성돼가고 있는 거를.
A blue sky and a thick forest are reflected on a lake like a decal. It looks like a traditional Korean landscape painting. But hidden symbols like Mickey Mouse and McDonald's represent the Western culture. The Western items against the background of the Korean landscape create a rare artistic atmosphere.
동양화인데 어떤 그 굉장히 상상력으로 가득한 회화를 보는 것 같은 느낌을 보기 때문에 그러니까 일반 동양화에서는 좀 뭐랄까 좀 찾아보기 힘든.
With the convergence of Korean and Western style paintings, the Korean art world is now showing off a wider artistic spectrum.
Neoprene suits are the latest fad in the fashion world. Their popularity soared in Korea after top actors and actresses appeared in them on TV. So here's more on the so-called neoprene look.
Dongdaemun is a fashion hub that's home to some 35,000 apparel stores. It's where the latest fashion trends are created. The latest trend these days is the so-called neoprene look. The neoprene style distinctively stands out from other fashion styles. Its soft fabric is reminiscent to that of a sponge.
소재 되게 독특하다고 되게 좋아하시더라고요. 한류 스타 전지현 씨께서도 이거 입으셔서 그런지 올해 들어서 이게 좀 더 잘 나가는 것 같습니다.
The neoprene look became all the rage since celebrities began wearing it. It wasn't long before the public followed suit. Many people fall for the neoprene look the moment they try it on.
소재는 우선 되게 가볍고요. 그리고 보온성이 되게 좋아요. 그리고 보시면 이제 구김이 잘 안 가서 입으실 때 보시면 굉장히 옷 라인이 되게 예뻐요.
In addition to design, the neoprene look emphasizes practical fabrics. You can find jackets, dresses, and skirts made of neoprene. The neoprene clothes look very much like diving suits. Actor Kim Soo-hyun was among the first to appear in a neoprene suit on TV. We visited a place that sells neoprene clothes for men, but so far, few customers have the courage to wear them in their daily lives. We met with designer Chung-wook Jun, who visited the store.
오버사이즈의 티셔츠를 디자인하고 싶었는데 그 잠수복 소재를 티셔츠에 접목하면 어떨까 하는 발상에서부터 시작했습니다.
Chung-wook Jun was the first Korean designer to present neoprene t-shirts in the global fashion arena. He says the reaction was unforgettable.
가을 겨울 파리 컬렉션에서 처음 그 네오플랜 티셔츠를 선보였어요. 그때는 사람들이 이게 뭐지? 이런 반응이었어요.
In just a few years, the neoprene look gained popularity among men. If you want to give the neoprene look a try, fashion experts say choose achromatic colors because the fabric is already eye-catching enough. As for the print, avoid too many patterns, but choose one that has a simple outstanding feature. Because neoprene clothes are voluminous, choose snug pants or skirts. This way you can wear neoprene clothes even in daily life without looking strange.
하나의 스타일 포인트는 네오플랜 자체가 멋지기 때문에 뭐 다른 액세서리를 약간 배제하는 것도 좋은 스타일링 법이라고 생각합니다.
Neoprene clothes don't wrinkle and have excellent thermo-keeping properties. As long as you don't mind the unique fit, nothing can beat the neoprene look in the cold season.
Now we'll take a look at the markets, followed by the world weather. Thank you. And that's it for this edition of News Today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again at the same time tomorrow. Goodbye.